what I heard as we're going through all the discussions with superintendents and meetings that I had, the primary area that they wanted that money to go to was the GEA, the Gap Elimination Adjustment. And that was put in, by the way, when we were in bad financial shape, when the New York City Democrats controlled the Senate, the Assembly, and the Governor's Office. And they imposed this cut by establishing this gap elimination. There was a budget gap. We got to eliminate it. So we're taking money away. And the districts still haven't caught up from that gap elimination adjustment that was done during the Democrats' control, the New York City Democrats' control. And we've been chipping away at it this year. We didn't just chip away at it. We got $600 million of that $1.1 million went for that purpose, to get rid of that reduction that took place several years ago. So I guess the moral of the story is there was substantial, twice the amount of increase for anything in this budget, twice the amount that we could possibly afford in view of the fact that we had a 2% goal, and it went in the right place. And I think most districts should be, if not overjoyed, they should at least be relieved that some of their budget problems will be taken care of by this the action of the state legislature.
Yeah, the Senate really led that, though, because if you take a look at the one House budgets, the budget proposals, the Senate's number was far higher.
Yeah, it was very much higher. It was like seven times higher than what the Assembly wanted to put in. And when we're negotiating, you know, if you want to, people have to take credit for something. That was our priority, and we ended up getting a huge number, much higher than what the Assembly wanted to do, and obviously higher than the governor wanted to do, because he didn't have that in his budget to that anywhere near that extent. So it's, I think it's an important victory for school districts.